Hi, my name is Heather Clark, and I am an instructor at the post-secondary school level, and I teach in the Fashion and Technology program with the Wilson School of Design at Kwantlen Polytechnic University in Richmond, BC.
And I'm Catherine Hay. I teach fashion at the secondary level in South Delta, British Columbia. And Heather and I both also teach at UBC, where we interact with teacher candidates, many of whom hope to become textiles teachers in the future. In this short presentation, we'll give you an idea of the inception, what our concept is, our process of generating content. We'll give you a quick tour of Stitched. We'll look at the big picture and how it has come full circle, and we'll end with our future plans. Within fashion, sewing, and textiles classrooms, it's very difficult and challenging to find a textbook or a credible video tutorial on the topic of sewing that covers the range of skills and techniques taught within these learning spaces. Typically, teachers make their own handouts to supplement the virtual and in-person demonstrations. Heather and I have both experienced similar frustrations in the search for credible and reliable sewing and textiles teaching resources, and have also found there to be a dearth of open education resources in this field. Together, we're developing a sewing-focused OER to support fashion and textiles education at multiple levels.
Stitched is a unique contribution to the field of OER. With this resource, we aim to meet the needs of applied fashion education. Content features a wealth of written instructions, photos, and videos that help us teach and demonstrate the variety of possibilities of achieving results in sewing and fashion design education. The open and online format of this OER enables educators to continually update the resource to meet current student needs and learning outcomes, while also reflecting on best practices within the apparel and fashion industry. Content in this OER supports skills and knowledge learned within the classroom while providing resources for further development. We are developing this OER in WordPress, with content grouped under headings with the goal of making information easy to find and readily accessible. The field of sewing and fashion is often traditionally seen as gender, something that seems to be slowly changing, which is wonderful news. Throughout developing some initial pieces of this project, we were very intentional with decisions so that this resource might not be viewed as being for a specific gender or group of people, but rather for anyone and everyone engaging in learning more about sewing and working with textiles. In one of our early meetings in which we discussed the idea of this OER and the direction it might take, Catherine and I started to map out content. Through mapping content, we considered what topics to include and determined under what headings they might fall. We quickly realized this would be a multi-year project, but this didn't hamper our enthusiasm. Throughout the decision-making process, we continually came back to our aims and goals of the project, considering what platform and content might best fit it, and guiding the direction of the look and feel of the overall resource. Once we had identified a theme, direction, and topics for the OER, we applied for and received an OER creation grant through KPU, Kwantlen Polytechnic University, and continued with work. As this resource is ultimately aimed at supporting student learning, we've sought to include students along the way in logo design and fabric print direction, as well as hiring a student assistant to aid in editing videos and uploading content to the OER site.
So this is our Stitched project vision, and this is the first page that just gives the user just a little bit of information about what the project is all about. And we especially like this part, additional content suggestions. Heather made this form where a user could actually make a request for something that we would include in the OER. And so we're looking forward to our first suggested topic. Up here, we've got things about fabric terminology, fibers and fabrics, fabric shopping and sourcing, sewing with fabric. Under fibers and fabrics, that breaks down to natural fibers, manufactured fibers, different fibers and fabrics, so we can kind of dive into that a bit with the natural fibers. The student that we hired to do some editing for us selected these beautiful pictures for us. And then a very similar page about the
manufactured fibers. But under sewing, and this is where we get really into it here, each of these subheadings will be equipped with its own video. We posted videos publicly on YouTube, and so our OER links to those videos.
Top stitching is a decorative element to the edge.
What we're building towards are pages like this. So under closures, we've got lots of different zippers. And for instance, this page, the lapped zipper, with its video, photographs, written instructions, and illustrations, so that we can hit different learning styles and different needs.
Fashion and sewing learning spaces are often a wonderful merging of understanding the practical application of theoretical knowledge. With the very hands-on nature of sewing and fashion education, this resource is being built with multiple types of media and information to broaden the students' understanding of the knowledge they have gained in these learning spaces. We're aiming to create not a traditional textbook with content to be memorized, but rather aiming to support student learning for long-term content. To help students in their learning process, an overall goal with this OER has been to create a resource that might be continually revisited and referenced to supplement and add to the learning process, both inside and beyond classroom spaces.
Because this OER serves multiple levels of education in fashion, it becomes a circular community. My students can use it at the secondary level, and then Heather's students can use it at the post-secondary level. Our UBC students who are teacher candidates in the textiles area can also use this when they come back into our classrooms to teach our students at the secondary level. So there's a lovely circularity to the collaborations that happen between secondary, post-secondary, and teacher candidates coming back into secondary.
We are currently still working on content generation for the resource and foresee that we will be working on this for some time yet. While work continues on the resource, we're looking forward to a soft launch, sharing what we have developed to date with select educators with a request for feedback and input to ensure this resource truly reflects what the community needs it to. Our aspirations for the OER is that it might be something that is continually updated and added to, and are resources for many learners for years to come. We can't wait for this OER to be adopted and used by multiple learners and foresee the support it might bring to their learning process. Thanks for joining us to hear about the stitched OER and the process we're going through in development. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out. We're happy to share any of our findings through creation, design, and development of resources.
Thank you so much for watching.
Thanks.